of the things that I've done have made an impact on the broader society. For example, the batteries that we've introduced.
Which was 40 years ago. I observed that electronics has shrunk, but batteries did not. So obviously there was a need.
Quite an extraordinary change in society as a result of the iPods and the laptop computers and the cell telephones. Earlier than that, I worked very hard on the first random access memory for the digital computer, which was a very important step in the evolution of the computer. Today, you put the computer in your shirt pocket.
You care about what you have left behind you. So anything that I ever touch, the first question is, do I help people?
That relationship between the chemist and the physicist and the engineer is something that I've tried to foster. I've had a very productive 25 years here.
The first thing that you do is you ask who in the world is the best in the field, and then try to recruit that person or that group.
What's fun is when a new concept emerges as a result of the dialogue you are having with somebody, and it's a shared moment, and those shared moments are what make all the work worthwhile.
At a place like the University of Texas, we have room for excellence in teaching, irrespective of research.
I don't think of what I get out of something, I think of what I put into something. And I always look at my role as trying to create the environment within which other people can be creative. Not a matter of what I do, but what, as a group, we manage to accomplish. We all have to aspire and be attracted by that which is first rate, whether it's first rate in the spirit, or first rate in your intellect, or first rate in whatever you do.
Theoretical exploration is what we build on, and there is nothing holier than uncovering a new truth.